The judiciary at that level should be instilled with the confidence that their judicial pronouncements shall never be held against them and that they represent the spinal cord of the justice delivery system. They should have the flexibility and the independence to render judgments in accordance with law without fear or favour. Any structure with a weak foundation will impact the edifice and eventually collapse. The justice delivery system at the foundation of the judicial structure needs to be strengthened both in terms of quantity and quality of manpower and infrastructure. Our trial court and district and session courts need to be empowered to deliver justice without fear and favor. Unless people at the bottom of the pyramid have the ability to withstand the pressure, the superstructure of the polity will not be able to deliver. I don't want to call the judiciary at the level of the trial court and district and session judges to be subordinate, because the judge sitting there delivers justice, and the question of being considered as subordinate to any authority is a contradiction in terms. The judiciary at that level should be instilled with the confidence that their judicial pronouncements shall never be held against them and that they represent the spinal cord of the justice delivery system. They should have the flexibility and the independence to render judgments in accordance with law without fear or favor. The effectiveness, fairness, and integrity of the courts impacts the perception of the public on the credibility of the entire judicial system. The fact that the trial court and district and session courts are loath to grant bail in matters of some significance itself is symptomatic of the malaise that has set in. In the course of my career, I have seldom witnessed the grant of bail at that level. This is not just my experience, but the Chief Justice of India has said often enough that court at the highest level is burdened with matters of bail because at the level of trial courts and district and session courts, bail seems to be an exception. Of course, it goes without saying that the grant of bail depends on the facts and circumstances of each case, but the pronouncements of the court have in the recent past adhered to the principle that bail is the rule and jail an exception. We've seen trends harking back to the law laid down in Gurbakh Singh Sibiya, wherein this principle has been enunciated and has now been reiterated by the Supreme Court of India in several recent judgments, even in relation to special acts which require stringent twin conditions. Liberty is the foundational substratum of a thriving democracy. Any attempt to throttle it impacts the quality of our democracy.